You are exiles. We are the exiles. We are the fallen.
You made the decision to go after Strange Flesh. This is about one thing. This is about us being consumed by another race. Let's get them in a host body system so we can destroy them. You're a kingdom divided. You're good and evil. You are the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. To rectify that situation, you got to be turned up. It's how you know that you know Jesus. And if it does add up to the scriptures, then it's not true.
Serpent race is an entity that manifests through the host body system, using the host body system as a medium to hunt angels. It's very obvious once you see it. The serpent race leaves a calling card, a manifestation that the serpent race was there. And that's easily seen all around us. The flesh was designed to hunt angels. Designed to hunt angels that would go for the forbidden fruit. And the serpent race, which is feeding a race of locusts from the pit, they're walking around all around us. It's a race that works through the host body system. Because it's everywhere. And it's made manifest in front of us all the time.
Are Americans part of certain that we stand at a defining hour? Halfway around the world, we are engaged in a great struggle in the skies and on the seas and sands. We know why we're there.
Do y'all know who the Skull and Bones Club are? Do you know why their number is 322? That's what the Lord showed me the other day, and I've been trying to get this out since I did that last video and half the audio was gone. Let me show you some. Y'all stay tuned because I'm going to give you scriptures never before understood. It's going to expose who these creatures are. I was looking for the right word. Here's Pops.
We are Americans, part of something larger than ourselves. For two centuries, we've done the hard work of freedom, and tonight, we lead the world in facing down a threat to decency and humanity. What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order. It is a big idea, a new world order, where diverse nations than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order where diverse nations.
It's a big idea. It's a new world order said by the Bushes, and it's what's on your U.S. currency as well. Let me show you John Kerry being asked about his involvement in the Skull and Bones Club. I'm going to show you biblically what it means. They're secret clubs, not a secret after tonight at all. Just like the Freemasons, the building, the square and compass, what did I show you? That the actual numbers at the square and compass on, I think it's 1217, it means builders and makers. The square and compass used by the Freemasons, the Lord let me see, because the Lord taught me the language of angels. Why would the square and compass be on the 1217? And in the Bible, that means the builders. The stone rejected by the builders is my God, by the way. See, I serve the Lord God of heaven. The stone rejected by the builders, you know, the Masons, Free Compass, 1217. I'll show it to you. Isn't that fascinating? Now, I'm going to show you something about this little group here, because their number 322, Skull and Bones, is biblical. That 322 for their number, did y'all know it's right out of the Bible? And did you know they're probably going to hate me for this, but that's okay. Let's look at John Kerry being asked about his involvement.
Skull and Bones from college and Bush, were you in the same secret society?
Well, that's all right. Let me answer his question.
Excuse me, what are you running for?
So I'm going to pause, and he just asked John Kerry, are you also a member of the Skull and Bones Club? Which he's still flying around making climate change deals for everybody. Like he still works for the U.S. government. I guess he does, but he says he doesn't. Sorry about that. Let's get it from a different angle. Pay attention. Here's a different angle. Watch this.
We impeach Bush, all right? Also, were you a member of Skull and Bones, College, and Bush? Were you in the same secret society?
Well, that's all right. Let me answer his question.
Excuse me, were you arrested? Whoa. Is anybody watching this? I'm not going to.
Now, you know what? I think he probably should be tased, don't you? I think a good tase would help, since all he did was say, aren't you a member of the Skull and Bones Club as well? Don't you think he deserves a good tasing?
Help! Help! Put your hands on your back! Sorry, man. Get off of me! I didn't do anything! Help me! Help me! Help! They're arresting me!
You're gonna be tased!
You'll be tased if you do not.
Can you let me go? I'll walk out of here.
Quiet,
just let me
down.
Go.
Hold on your stomach.
Do it now.
Put your hands behind your back.
I think if everybody this situation.
You don't have an option.
Hold on. I'll answer his question. And, unfortunately, he's not available to come up here and swear me in as president.
Why are they arresting me? Can someone do something here?
Let me just see arrested. Because it's a very important question.
What did I do? Get off me! No way! Get off me! Get the fuck off me, man! I didn't do anything!
Well, hang on. You did do something. You dared to ask John Kerry if he's a member of the Skull and Bones Club, like a lot of other politicians.
Don't tase me, bro! Don't tase me! I didn't do anything! Ow! 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 Ow!
you know, he probably needed a good taste just for asking the question. Okay. Let's continue. I just don't want you to forget the video right before this one. We were being explained to that it's a big idea that needs to get out there. Remember, these guys have a big idea for us. Hang on, let's listen.
And humanity. What is it sitting down? A threat to decency and humanity. What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order, where diverse...
Okay, a new world order. And now they're rolling it in, and they're making sure it's even on your medical chart to see if you should be tracked, maybe, if you didn't get a SSSSS, serpent, sheep, slaughter, slingshot. Just hang on, because we're going to the Bible now in just a minute. We're going to have so much Bible coming up right now that if you don't recognize where you're at after I show you this video, then I don't know if I can help you. You should see very clearly. I'm sorry, I'm going to try and dial it up a little bit. My mind is just overloaded with... I've been under attack for the last 2 days since I tried to get this last video up. It's been unbelievable. Anyway, but here we go. We're going to get this out. You're going to see it. It's in the Bible. 3:22. But when you see what it means, and you're going to see that the Lord gave me the resolution. The resolution of these guys that are in their special little 3:22 club. The Lord showed me the simplicity of the resolution, to where their little secret club is no longer the secret club they think it is anymore. Because now the word's out. And now that the word's out, then it's no longer secret anymore. And you know who and what entity is embedded within it. There's an entity. You'll get to see that entity. Now, this guy right here, that's this guy right here.
You were both in Skull and Bones, the secret society.
It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go wild.
I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the website.
Number 322?
I haven't seen it.
You start to lose?
No, I'm not going to lose.
If you did, what would you do?
Well, I don't plan on losing. I've got a vision for what I want to do for the country. See, I know exactly where I want to lead.
You were both in Skull and Bones, the secret society.
It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go wild.
I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the website.
Number 322?
The number 322, you heard him, right? You guys heard that. 322, do you know what it is? I do. Get out your Bibles. Get out your show notes. You're going to want to mark this down so you can show anyone you want to. I got to get some drops for my eyes. I'm going to pause this. You guys, okay, I'm going to try and move around a little bit, get a little bit spunky. I'm exhausted, but I'm going to do this no matter what. Okay, guys, so stay with me, please. Get ready. Here you go. It's time to have your jaw flop open. We're at the end of all things. The Skull and Bones Club is no longer a secret. You're going to know exactly what it is. Exactly. And you're going to know exactly what their big idea is, their new world order. You're going to know exactly what it is by the time I'm done with this video. If you have eyes to see and you've been coming to this ministry for any length of time, if you've been here for the long haul, you're going to be so supremely blessed. You're going to be like, oh my gosh, you're going to know the truth and the truth will set you free. Jesus said you'll know the truth and the truth will set you free. Did you know the Skull and Bones Club? Did you know they know the truth and they're hiding it from you? Did you know that? Did you know that? It's the glory of Elohim to conceal a matter. It's their glory to conceal it. It's a secret. And you can't know it. Because if you find out, they won't be able to control you anymore. And if they can't control you, then they can't rule over you. And then, but they gotta make sure that they keep the sheeple in compliance. Because they make for fine ingredients for customizing anything. Here come the little deviants. For those of y'all that know what I'm talking about. How stupid is that, right? Where does that come from? Comes from the truth. Okay, sit tight. Here you go. Ready? Here we go. All right, folks. God bless you guys. Okay, here we go, guys. Let's just tear into this. So here we go. Open up your show note folders. You're going to go to the This Is The End show notes. That should be very easy to find these days. I'll put it in the description box again. You go to Special Projects 2 right here. We're working on this folder right here. Imrana Raptor SSS. Yeah, I say that on purpose. Like, you say that letter out loud right there. What's that letter? M, and then say that one, and that one. I like to say Imrana because in their algorithms won't be as annoying. Okay, so here we go. We'll open this up. And I want you guys to open up this folder. And we're going to go down, and there's going to be some pictures in here. I made these pictures with Dave the Wave for you to make it so easy for you, so y'all will understand the simplicity to understand what the three crosses were about, to understand what it means that her feet take hold on hell, to understand a physical representation of your spark of holiness being taken from you. That's the new world order that they're after. They want your spark of holiness because they're in the Skull and Bones Club. There's a very special club, and they, unless you're one of the top dogs and you're one of the boys in the club, you don't get to know the big secrets. But they do, because don't worry, they're going to handle everything for you. All right, let me show you what it is. Let's go to Isaiah 40. Open up Esword, please. Well, I've already given it away right here, so it's going to be Genesis 3:22, but we're going to come back to it. See Genesis 3:22 right here? We'll be right back there. First, we're going to go to Isaiah 40 because it's important that you see things come roll out in an order that makes it very understandable for you. Okay, read these words with me. Comfort ye my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem. Okay, now, before we go any further, I know there's some newcomers here. I know there's some people that don't understand the difference between El, the Almighty God, Elohim, the Lord God, the self-existent eternal Jehovah Elohim, the generic use of the word Elohim. There's a lot to it, but if you've been around for a while, I'm sure you've gotten a pretty good solid grasp of it. The word God in the Bible is used very generically sometimes as the word Elohim, like, this is my plumber, so this is my God, Elohim. But then there's very specific words for God. This is my super number one plumber that started everything, and we'll call him the self-existent eternal Jehovah. And he's not just a plumber, he's the plumber that started all plumbing. And I'm just giving an example so you understand. There's nuances and differences in the word Elohim and the word the Lord God, self-existent eternal Jehovah. So I'm just going to leave it there for you for just a minute. But you will understand, especially those of y'all that have been around, y'all are going to go, oh my Lord, Johnny, I cannot believe what you just gave us. The Lord is giving you a gift right now through me. That's why my name means Yahweh is given. He uses me to give to you. That is an appellation of my name. Okay, comfort ye my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem. Now look at the word Jerusalem. See, it's Yerushalayim. Yerushalayim. And it means a dual. It says a dual. In allusion to its two main hills, the true pointing, at least of the former reading, seems to be that of H3390, corresponding to Jerusalem, probably from the passive participle of 3384 and H7999, which means founded and peaceful. See it right there? Founded and peaceful, Jerusalem. And it's saying, speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her. Okay, now this is very important for y'all to understand now. Okay, you know when the Lord God, it's like before all of us started, before the whole thing, there is a singularity. And when he's willing, the Lord God's willing, in order for everything to exist, he is willing to lay down his own life before the foundation of a world. I know that's hard to wrap your brain around, but think about the singularity that gets split in half and then the other half goes down in the opposite direction. Just like the circle, you take the circle and then you split it in half and then the other half goes down the other way, like an S, like that, like an S on its side. And one represents male energy and the other represents female energy. And that's the system that you're trapped in. That's what you are trapped in. And I'm going to prove it. And I'm going to show you the Skull and Bones Club. They know it. They know everything Jonathan Kleck's been telling you about. If you want to get converted, you got to get inverted. Your other eye has to be inverted. You have to turn the world upside down to see the truth. And the reason that they call themselves a Skull and Bones Club is because the flesh, your body, is the Skull and Bones Club. And they're the original inhabitants. They're the ones that started it. They're the parthenogenic masters of the human race. They are the ones that know that if you come into their club, they own you. But you don't even know the big secret because, see, they run the Skull and Bones Club, and they don't ever want you to get out. Did you know it says, you know, John the Baptist, when he's a voice crying in the wilderness, and I very much relate to John the Baptist because the Lord sent me to the desert and showed me that I was something like John the Baptist, a voice crying in the wilderness. But did you ever notice how I always do this with my hands to show you that represents you being converted? Because you have one eye that goes up, you have one eye that goes down to the pit. You are a dual. You're good and you're evil. The good goes up, the evil comes down. But it takes place, the fight, the battle, takes place within a box called your body. You know, like the Kaaba. Like the Kaaba has their little box in Mecca with a vagina on the corner. That's pretty convenient, right? Well, so if you have good and evil within the same box, and the Skull and Bones Club, those guys, Skull and Bones, well, what is the box? It's your body. Oh, the Skull and Bones. So see, those are the guys that know the secret, and they actually know how what it takes to get out of it, but they know you'll never get out of it. Well, most of you won't get out of it. The only way to get out of it is turn back to your creator. You know, when I mentioned the voice crying in the wilderness, he says every mountain and hill shall, every valley shall be exalted, right? Every valley shall be exalted and every hill and mountain shall be brought low. I'm going to show you my hand right there. You see the word hill and valley? So hills are on top, valleys are on the bottom, right? So I'm going to go like this. So every valley shall be exalted and every hill shall be made low. Do you get it? Every valley, the valley's being exalted and the hill is being made low. So all I'm doing is I'm enfolding one of my hands. I do it all the time. I do it nonstop. I show you guys that's the key to the kingdom of heaven. Jesus said, I'm going to call you Petros, little piece of rock. And upon this Petra, I will build my church. And I'll give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. And the gates of hell will not prevail against it. Because it's so perfect that when you're on the rock and the understanding that the Lord's given me, nothing can move you. Nothing will let, no wind of doctrine will come along. No just BS preacher will come along and move you. You'll be like, I'm on the rock. I've been converted. The word converted means turned quite around. If your eye be single, the word be single means to fold together. Every valley shall be exalted. So see, it says valley down there on my fingers. That one, that finger, I cut the tendon in my hand so it won't straighten out. Every valley shall be exalted. So how do you do that? And every hill shall be made low. So there you go. So there's just another example of it. But I've shown you over and over and over again in Isaiah and Jeremiah and all the Habakkuk, all these other scriptures, it always says to make single, you invert it. Woe unto them who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord. You know, like the Skull and Bones Club. They carry out their schemes in secret and think no one will see them or know what they're doing. They turn everything upside down. So I'm going to show you some secrets about the Skull and Bones Club tonight. About even their like little picture that they draw. Y'all remember the Adidas original, don't you? Okay, well, they're like the Adidas original. Okay, here we go. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her her warfare. See, her warfare is accomplished. I want you to think about the idea of Adam and Eve, and when the Lord God is willing to create a system and allow a singularity to be split in half. And so he takes Eve out of Adam's side while he puts him to sleep. And it means to stun or stupefy with sleep or with death. So Adam is stupefied with sleep or with death. Eve is taken out of his side. It means to bend or to curve. That's why it's the rib. To bend or to curve, and then it goes back the other way, forming the very system I just showed you, right side up, arch, and an upside down arch. So one eye that's got an arch up, and one eye that's got an arch down, just like that. That represents the system. But it has to take place, the battle between evil and good, it takes place within your body, which is the Skull and Bones Club. And see, they know that, and they know that you'll never get out of it unless you turn the world upside down. And I'm going to show you that now. Ready? Watch. Here it is in the scriptures. Speak comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her. Now remember, Eve was taken out of his side. And until you discover your other half, you are not made whole. So you have to discover her, basically. And that her warfare is accomplished. Look at the word warfare. A mass of persons or figurative things, especially regularly organized for war, an army by implication, a military campaign. See it? An army, an implication, a campaign. An army, a battle, a host, service, and soldiers. You see it? So we're in Isaiah 40, verse 2. This is so important that you learn these scriptures right now. So you're in Isaiah 40, you're in verse 2. Now watch this. Tell Jerusalem that her warfare is accomplished. What does that mean? It means to fill. It means to be full of, to accomplish, to confirm, to be at an end, to be fenced, to gather selves together, to have fully, completely. Her warfare is accomplished. That's what it means. Her iniquity is pardoned. Look at the word iniquity. Perversity, moral evil. See right here it says crooked or to bow down. So her iniquity, her bowing down and making crooked and perversion is pardoned. To satisfy a debt, reconcile, pardon. You see it right there? Her iniquity, the word perversity, evil, moral fault, it means bowing down, her to do amiss, to bow down, to make crooked, to pervert. Now, who was it that in the fall, when you look at the garden, who was the first one? It was the woman, wasn't it? And then Adam's like, well, the woman you gave me. It's like, good. Anyway, but it was Eve, wasn't it? Okay, well, when you have Adam and Eve and you have Genesis 2 and you have the singularity, the whole circle, but then you split that circle at the side out of his side and you take Eve a curve back the other way to bend back the other way. Right here in Isaiah when it says her iniquity, because see, it used to be founded and peaceful. The two were one together. But when you split them and you make Adam and then Eve out of her and it's upside down and backwards the other way now, right here in Isaiah, it's saying, well, her iniquity, her sin, her bowing down is now pardoned, right here, pardoned. It means to satisfy a debt, to pardon, to reconcile. For she hath received of the Lord's hand double. Now, you got to understand this. This is a good thing. How do you get reconciled back to God? What does it say? Your eyes become single. What does it say? Jesus came to open the dungeons, to redouble the eyes of the blind. That's what it means. It means to redouble your eyes. That's why I put hills on my hand. Every valley shall be exalted. So to make that valley exalted, I go up. What do I do to make the hill go down? I go like that. I enfold it. That's how I do it. I just fold my eyes together. My whole body's full of light. Her iniquity is pardoned. She hath received of the Lord's hand. Ready? She has received to take, to accept, to enfold. See right here? Enfold. To mingle. She has enfold of the Lord's hand. Now pay attention now. Of the Lord. Who is the Lord? The Lord is the self-existent eternal Jehovah that opens wide. That's who the Lord is. The self-existent eternal Jehovah that opens wide. That's who Yahushua is. She has received, she has enfolded of the Lord's hand. Pay attention. Look at the word. Look at what you're looking at right here and look at the colors. The open one indicating power. Means and direction. A hand, the open one. Pay attention now. A hand, the open one, indicating power, means and direction. Where is our God? He's in heaven. Where is the enemy? In the pit. Don't forget, female, her feet take hold on hell. So you've got to invert the world to see the truth, unless you make the things of the right hand as those of the left, and those of the left as those of the right, those above as those below. You will have no knowledge of the kingdom of heaven. You ready for the skull and bones reveal? Y'all ready? Their secret's no longer a secret anymore. Praise God. What does it say right here, though? Right here in Isaiah, her warfare is accomplished. Watch this. Her Jerusalem means founded and peaceful because you've been made whole again. Her warfare, a mass of persons organized for war. The first place you see that is in Genesis 2, when the host of heaven is finished by Elohim. When Elohim creates man in his own image, ready? Genesis 2. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and the host of them. And on the seventh day, Elohim ended his deputyship. Ready? Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the hosts. Look at the word host. 6635, what does it say? A mass of persons, or figurative things, organized for war, an army, by implication, a campaign. So the first place you ever see this word right here is in Genesis 2, when Elohim ended his work, his deputyship, see, deputyship, so you know it's not the sheriff, because it's the deputy doing the deputy thing. Are you ready? And they know it. Watch. Back to Isaiah 40. I want to drill it into you. I'm going to say it over and over again so you get it. Speak comfortably to Jerusalem. Founded and peaceful. An allusion to its two main hills. Think of two ups. Two ups. Two main hills. Ready? If you have one hill that's up, but one's down, one's a valley, you have a hill and then a valley. That's not founded in peaceful. But if you get the other one turned up, that's founded in peaceful because they're no longer in opposition to each other. That's a hill. That's a valley. When you turn the other one up, founded in peaceful, you're no longer at odds with yourself. Ready? Watch this. Here it is, guys. Look what it says. For her iniquity is pardoned, for she hath received to infold of the Lord's hand. Look at the word hand. It says a hand, the open one, indicating power, means, and direction. She has received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A duplicate. Oh my God, a duplicate. A double. Oh my God, to fold together, just like Jonathan Kleck has been telling us since the beginning of his ministry, that the Lord God told him to read some shirt he was carrying. He had a pile of clothes in his hands. Read the tags in the clothes you're carrying. And the first one said 100% nylon. So he's reading a tag that said 100% nylon? That doesn't make any sense, God. Well, turn it upside down. 100% no lion. What's the word nylon upside down and backwards? No, N-O-L-Y-N. And here it all is, right here in the Bible, to show you that we are the new Jerusalem. Ready? Founded in peaceful because I enfolded the other one. And that's why we're referred to as the bride of Christ, because the bride is kind of like a feminine relationship, but it's to show that you've been joined together in one thing, kind of like the act of a bride and groom. So here it is. For her iniquity is pardoned, she hath received, look, to infold of the Lord's hand, meaning the open one, very important, indicating power, means, and direction. She has received double, look, a duplicate. This is the payment, you guys, to fold together for all her sins and offense. Sometimes habitual sin, sinfulness, to miss, to forfeit, to lead astray, or to condemn. Okay, now, but I haven't shown you guys the Skull and Bones Club yet. Are you ready? They're going to hate Johnny. That's all right. Here you go. Ready? Genesis 3, Skull and Bones Club. You know, the serpent said to the woman, oh, you can eat from every tree in the garden except the tree in the middle. And then he said, oh, you shall not touch it lest you die. Shall not touch means euphemistically to lie with the woman. Well, where did, and so if you have this and one size up and then you get to the horizontal plane and you have a dot right here, and then at that dot, instead of going back and finishing the circle, you go down the other way, then you have one that's right side up and then one that's upside down. Over, one's going one way, one's going down the opposite way. Okay, ready? Here you go. Here you go. And unto Adam and his wife did the Lord God make coats of skin. It means coats. It means to cover with a garment or a robe, or like a shirt or a garment. A skin, by implication, a hide. This is where you're getting your naked bodies. And he clothed them. And the Lord God said, now look, you said it. The Lord, the self-existent eternal Jehovah said, behold, lo, the man is become as one of us. Now, let me ask you a question. As one of who? Well, there's the Lord God. And then who's the opponent to the Lord God? Isn't it Satan? Lucifer? Well, Lucifer's the anointed cherub that covereth, but his attachments to the pit. Satan's the accuser of the brethren, right? Well, what does it say right here? The man is become. The man is become. Look at the word become. To exist, to come to be, to come to pass. The man is become as one of us. Look at what this says. United. The man has become united with us. So the man is a box that houses good and evil, male and female, one up, one down, in opposition to each other. And that's the box that houses it right now, because it's put in a box called, well, what did he do? He clothed them with flesh, and he with flesh he did clothe them, and he gave them coats of skin, and he clothed them. And the Lord God said, behold, the man has become to exist, to come to be, come to pass, as one of us, properly united to know, to ascertain by seeing. So the word to know, good and evil, recognition, designation, punishment, acknowledge, acquaintance, to know good and evil. And get ready, here you go. Are you ready for the punchline? See, because the Skull and Bones Club knows, the Skull and Bones is the box. It is the clubhouse. It is the He-Man Woman Haters Club up in the tree, so to speak. It is your little treehouse. That's what the Skull and Bones Club is. It's a treehouse of the upside down race, because they're the ones that sets the trap. Here it is. Man has become as one of us to know good and evil. Now lest he put forth his hand. What's the word hand say right here? A hand as the open one. Remember where you saw that last? Wasn't it in Isaiah 40? Now lest he put forth his hand and take also of the tree of life and eat and live forever. So do you understand how important it is to understand the scripture? Do you know I've never seen anyone that understands it? Ready? Unless he does that. Do you believe me? Unless he put forth his hand and take also of the tree of life. Look at the word take. What does it say? To take, accept, to enfold. Of the tree of life and eat and live forever. So when you turn back to the Lord your God, your eye gets enfolded. There's an Adam part of you and there's an Eve part of you. And when you meet your other half, like by turning the world upside down, you're meeting your other half in spirit. Do you understand? And you're made whole. Why do you think it said right here? Look at this. Look what it says right here in Genesis 2. And it says, and Adam gave names to all the cattle and the fowl and to every beast of the field. And to Adam there was not found a help meet for him. A help, an aid, a meet for him. A part opposite. Oh my God. Over and against the other side. There was not a meet for him. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep. A deep sleep. A lethargy by implication. A trance. A lethargy. A trance. To stun. To stupefy with sleep or with death. That's why the Bible says, arise, O sleeper. Wake up from the dead. You regain your senses. You regain your, whoa, where am I? Like the night I woke up, I'm like, what's going on? The whole world had changed right in front of my eyes. Uh-huh. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to stun, to stupefy with sleep or with death, to fall, to cast down, to cast out, to cease, to divide, fall upon Adam, and he slept, and he took to enfold one of his ribs, as curved as the leaf of a door, that is a leaf. He took one of his ribs to curve, to limp as if by one side. If you have 1 foot up and 1 foot down, 1 foot goes to heaven, 1 foot goes to the pit. Her foot takes hold on hell. You get it? It's solved. Y'all get this? It's awesome. Now I'm going to show you some imagery. Oh my God. So Genesis 3:22. Now all these words, we understand what they mean. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made a woman, and he brought her unto man. Oh my God. Here we go. Now watch this. And here we go. And here it is in Genesis 3:22. The skull and bone clothes. Because they just got their skull and bones. They just got their coats of skins. Coats of skins. They got their little box to be in. And the Lord God said, behold, the man has become as one of us to know good and evil, lest he put forth his hand and take to enfold, to mingle, and also of the tree of life, which is up. That's where our God is from, up. That down is the god of the pit. I told you that's why Islam prays with their head to the ground. That's why they all walk counterclockwise around a box and put their hand in a vagina or kiss a vagina. And when you put your head in that hole, it inverts you. So crazy. Ah, no way. Yes, and let's go back to Isaiah. See, we are Jerusalem. We become Jerusalem when we get converted. So we are the new Jerusalem. Ready? Because look, you have, okay, I'll do a curve like this, like a rainbow. So you have one that's up, you have one that's down. They're in opposition to each other. But when you get the one that's down up, both your eyes are up. You have like two hills. Founded in peaceful. You have two ups. Now let me just show you the cross and you'll understand this. I made some images for you. Okay, speak comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned, for she hath received, she has enfolded to mingle of the Lord's hand, indicating power, the open one. Double! A duplicate to fold together for all her sins. Now, ready? Now, everything you would want to see right now to prove it all is all right here in this folder. And I'm simply going to go through this and show it to you. And you guys have pure gold waiting for you right now. Ready? So let me show you some imagery. Here is an image of hell wants you. This is hell. I want you. But remember, the woman, her feet take hold on hell. Now think of one that's attached to hell. But because that's part of you, you got one up, one down. That system has a hold of you because that female energy, everywhere you go, you have your own worm and you're attached to it in the pit. So you have to invert it. Sorry. You have to invert it. And when you do, your eyes become single and your whole body's full of light and it cuts the cord to the pit. And hell no longer has a hold on you. Because you've redoubled your eyes. You've been redoubled. Now, let me just go through some images nice and slow. I don't want to be in a hurry. I want you guys to get this. Let me give you some really good examples. So here's the guy at the Vatican in the slave collar, right? There he is. There's the guy right here. But underneath him, his slave collar right here, yellow is an eye. Yellow is an eye, nose, fangs. Pink tongue, that's a beast. He's in the beast system, which is this twin system. See, there's a fetus here and a fetus here. Now, when you turn him upside down, he becomes a bug from the pit. Now, here's a very simple thing. Here's an eye. Think of that pupil as a trough to a dimension where evil goes. That hole right there goes to evil, and there's the little worm that's attached to it, and then Satan's the king of all those, and these are all under his care like a queen of a hive. So that line goes to that eye. But if you invert the world and you turn the world upside down and you see the truth, Wow, all of a sudden you've enfolded your eye, your eyes have been made single, and then you have to see the truth, and then you kind of wrestle with it a little bit, and then you accept it, and then you let the truth live in you, and you tell the Lord you're sorry, and he commutes all your sins. He expunges your record, and you no longer have a worm attached to you. That's why there's stuff like this in the Vatican, because they know. Now, let me just keep showing you. Now, let me give an example. I've did all these images. Y'all remember the tattoo on the guy's back that's got the angel and the devil? Let's look at that tattoo for a second, because you're going to see it in this presentation. I just want to make sure that you see and understand it. Okay, so here's this guy's back. The whole thing is a dead sheep, because we're in the system that we're in is you're looked at like basically you're a sheep. You're the skull and bones that the Skull and Bones Club manages, because they're your owners, because they know the big secret. Okay, so here you go. There's right here, the whole thing's a sheep, but that eye right there, that's really a demon, and that's an angel. And the angel and the demon are yoked together, and there's the devil looking up from the pit. So let me just show you that, because I colored it in for you. So there's the devil. He's looking up from the pit, and he knows that the struggle between the angel and the demon, he knows that struggle always goes in his favor. He always gets the energy from that fight, unless the angel in you turns back and says you're sorry. When you turn back to the Lord and you say, oh, when you invert the world and you see, oh my God, what's going on? Why is the Virgin a dead sheep? Why is the Vatican a snake? Why is the snake eating angels? Why is this crap all over the world? Why do I see it everywhere? Because you got born into it. You got born into their system. You understand? Now watch. So here it is. Now, take a look at that tattoo. We're going to superimpose it on the crosses of Calvary. Now, y'all get ready. We got some pictures to look at. Let me just kind of scan. Okay, let's start right with the scripture. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem. Her sins are pardoned. She has received double. That means she has been enfolded, and she is a duplicate. Now, she's made whole. So she's no longer at war with herself. Here you go. Now watch. If your eye be single in Luke, the light of the body is the eye. Yes or no? Does it say that? It's just a yes or no. And if the eye, therefore, is single, the whole body is full of light. Does that say properly folded together? Yes or no? So your eye being single, 5C573. 573. If your eye is single. So let me ask you a question. How is your eye made single? It's folded together. See, I'm going to fold it and put it together. That's why Jesus said, and that's why the Bible says in Ephesians 2, his purpose was to make one new man from the two, because there's an angel and a demon at war. That's why Genesis 2, it says, and the host was organized for war. Well, what host? Well, what happened in Genesis 1? Let us make man in our image. So in the image of Elohim created he him, male and female created he them. And the lying churches tell you that's the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. No, it's not. The word Selem is image. Let us make man in our Selem. The word Selem means, and I quote, to shade, to make darker. Then it says a phantom, an illusion, so something that's not real. Then it says a representative figure, especially an idol. Are we supposed to make idols? No, we're not. Then it says, yeah, a vain show and a poser, which I've met a lot of posers in my life. They're just phonies. They're fakes. Okay, so if the light of the body is the eye, therefore if your eye is single, 573, folded together, yes or no? There it is. That's the resolution of Genesis 3:2:2. Okay, so let's keep going here. Now, Hebrews 11:13, yes. These all died in faith. It's talking about all the ones that went before us, not having received the promises, but having seen them from afar off, And they were persuaded of them, which is what Jonathan Kleck's trying to do for you. I'm trying to persuade you. Look at how obvious is it. It's stupid obvious. It's not even obvious. It's stupid obvious. Hello? It's so stupid obvious. Ready? They were persuaded of them. And they embraced them and they confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. Yes or no? Okay, what is the word strangers, pilgrims? It says an alien alongside that is a resident foreigner. You know, remember Taylor Swift in her video called My Lover? She's sitting upside down on the ceiling with the black eye with the big round light ball in between her and the black eye. The round light ball represents one of God's princes who's been inverted. And the black eye represents the doppelganger. And she's playing a game that says, devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. Let's look at that one time just so we can see it. I'm going to leave this right here. I'm going to move this right here. And we're going to look at a Taylor Swift thing. So it's just a yes or no answer. Again, is that Taylor Swift sitting on the ceiling upside down with a big round white ball of light between her and her lover that's a black guy? Yes or no? Why, it sure is. Okay, well, let's see what they're doing. They're playing a game called Devil's Roll the Dice and Angels Roll Their Eyes. It does say that, doesn't it? Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. Is the number right here a 2 and a 4 and a 1, 241? It's a yes or no. Is this a 3, 3 and a 6? It's a yes or no. So you know what 241 means and 336? Well, 241 means of another race, of another nation, a foreigner. Well, aren't we foreigners, aliens, alongside an original? See, we're an Elohim alongside an original. We're a ball of light because angels, God's princes, Kokab, means a round, shining ball. That's what it means. See, the Lord taught me their vocabulary and their language on purpose. That's why he told me I had to read the Bible translating to Hebrew and Greek on the fly. He did years ago, and I was like, you got to be kidding me. And he's like, that's what you're going to do. And he was, now I know why, because now I can see it. So, of another race, does it say 241 allogenes, like allogenes, like genetics, C-G-G-E-N-E-S, genus, allogenes, of another race, yes or no? Does it say a foreigner, yes or no? Okay, so that's 241. And then what about 336? 336, ana eresis, a taking away of life, killing, slain, murder, taking up a destroying, slain, and murder, put to death. So putting to death another race, yes or no? The Skull and Bones Club.
Okay, come on into our clubhouse. Y'all want to play? It's a secret. I can't tell you. It's super secret. But we have a really big vision for the world. We want y'all to come in as slaves. We'll use your energy to build the world we want. Then we're going to kill y'all and get rid of you. That's the end. That's why the Bible says her latter part is as bitter as wormwood. Told ya. Got him, dude. Y'all know what you're looking at? Y'all understand what, do you understand what you're looking at? So let's see, these guys, yeah, they yuck it up, guys, yuck it up. There, guys.
We're both in Skull and Bones, the secret society. It's so secret we can't talk about it. What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go wild.
I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the website.
Number 322.
You're going to lose.
No, I'm not going to lose.
Okay. All right, bud. There you go, buddy. No one better ever ask you about it, right? Or you guys will do this to them. Let's see. What do you guys do to people that ask you about it?
Were you in the same secret society?
Well, that's all right. Let me answer his question.
Excuse me. What are you running people? Whoa, whoa, whoa.
So let me ask you a question. Why would people be clapping that some guy's getting drug out because he asked a very legitimate question? Aren't you members of the Skull and Bones 322? What is 322? Skull and Bones. And to Adam and his wife, he gave coats of skin, flesh. Skull and Bones Club. Busted. Yes, they are busted. And now you know, it even says, unless he stretched forth his hand, the open one, and take from the tree of life to enfold, because the tree of life has been inverted in their system. You want me to show you some logos from the Skull and Bones Club? You guys want to totally freak out? You guys want to completely and utterly freak out? Now, y'all remember the Adidas original where they're all hanging upside down, right? Let me show you a little cool something that the Lord gave me, a supernatural gift that he lets me see what's hidden in artwork. Let me just ask you, let's just pick something. And pretty simple. It's a yes or no answer. Is that an image of a dead sheep right there? Moses the pug, super cool dude, made these for us. That's an image of the Virgin, but it's really a dead sheep. You can see the sheep, can't you? Without the gift part, see, it's a dead sheep. Oh yeah, it's a dead sheep. Why would it be a dead sheep? Well, let me show you a couple things. Okay, here we go. Now here is the Skull and Bones. Let's see, maybe I can show you one. There you go, right here. There you go. See the Skull and Bones right here? There's different images of it, but let me show you what I can see. It's a tree. They made it a tree. And there's people that are walking out of the tree. It just depends. So this is a tree. See the tree of the knowledge of good? See the tree right here? I made it green and there's a trunk. But look what's coming out. These are people that are walking in a row this direction. See, there's a person, there's their head, there's their head, there's their head. So there's a tree, and they're walking this direction. Now watch, because by getting you in the Skull and Bones, the box that you're in, that's how they murder you. There you go, there's Skull and Bones. See? See the tree? They just put it in plain sight. There's the trunk, and here's the people walking this way, the upside down. Adidas original. I see you. I see you guys. You're busted. You're totally busted. Oh, let's take a little look here. Let's see what's going on here. Okay, well, this is fascinating. There's a couple hands. There's a hand that's on the two. This is a clock. It's an interesting clock that they made sure it looks like it's got devil horns, doesn't it? But you have a hand right here on the two, and you got one straight up. You got one going over here, it looks like, as well. This looks like the shorthand. This looks like the main longhand. So that would be 200, two zeros, 2 o'clock straight up. That would be Locus. Hey, Locus, what's up? Why would you have a human skull right there? Why would you have your big X? Oh, like the end of the endecagram. See the triangle coming together here. See the black triangle here, Skull and Bones Club. See the X? There you go. These guys look like a swell group of guys, especially this guy. This eye's open a little too wide. See that eye? Look at that eye. I'm sure that's the eye that goes to the pit for that guy. Anyway, there you go. Okay, now let's talk about, you are my witnesses, declares the Lord. Isaiah 43. You are my witnesses, saith the Lord. That my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God form. Look at the word for God, El. Let's go to Isaiah 43:10. Isn't this fun, you guys? When you know you got him, when you know you got him. You don't think you got him, you got him. They're got. They're busted. There's no way out. You are my witnesses, saith the Lord. What's the word witness? It means abstractly, testimony, that is a recorder, like what Jonathan Kleck does. He records everything. And then a prince. Oh, you're one of my princes. And the root of the word prince is to duplicate, to encompass, and to restore as a sort of reduplication. Do it, boss. Each one learning by never learning a kiss. Remember the CIA challenge coin? You are my witnesses to duplicate, to restore, to reduplicate. Like, speak tenderly to Jerusalem. Because her warfare is accomplished. Because you've got two main hills instead of one right side up, one upside down. Every valley shall be exalted and every hill shall be made low. You know where that is? That's in Isaiah 40. Well, let me show you this one more time. I'm just going to kill him with scriptures now. Scriptures is going to do the job here. This is it. The devil cannot handle the scriptures. That's what he hates the most. Here it is. Speak comfortably to Jerusalem. What does Jerusalem say? A duel in allusion to its two main hills. The true pointing, at least the former reading, blah, 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 means founded and peaceful. And it says her warfare is accomplished. A mass of persons organized for war. That's straight out of Genesis 2. And the host was finished by the deputy. Her warfare is accomplished, to fill, to be full, to be fenced, to gather cells together. For she hath received to enfold of the Lord's hand, the open one, indicating power. She has received double, a duplicate. She has enfolded and folded together for all her sins. So she's been cleaned. So how does the Bible tell you you've been cleaned? How's it say it right there? You've been folded together. That's how you know you've been cleaned. I told you, 100% nylon. Turn it upside down. Read it. What's the word nylon upside down? No lying. 100% truth from the very beginning. The first thing the Lord God ever told me was the resolution of the entire Bible. It's like freak out. You guys getting this? Okay, let's keep going. There's so many more now. Now, listen, you know, now all the folders bear witness to the truth of what I've shown you. Stop and think about that. All the folders I have now, all the information proves out like a giant long scientific experiment, and now all the scriptures are on my side. It's like all the false prophet hunters. I mean this. I love you in Christ, and if I could reach over the cliff to try and save you, I would. Maybe you should go back to the Lord and throw yourself at the mercy of the judge and admit publicly that you lied and you were wrong. Maybe he'll forgive you, but I just don't think you got it in you, to be honest. Anyway, even though it's proven, that's called delusional. So I'm proving it using the word of God. Look what it says. You are my witnesses, says the Lord. What is the word witness? To duplicate. To encompass and to restore as a form of reduplication, a prince. Now look, let's go back to Isaiah 43 verse 10. Very important, 43 verse 10. I want you to see this. Very important word. You are my witnesses, saith the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me, there was no God form. Look at the word God. What's the word right here, God? It's El, the Almighty God. It's not Elohim. It's El. El, the Almighty God. See it? Before me, there was no El formed, neither shall there be after me. I am the self-existent eternal Jehovah. So there was no L formed. I am the self-existent eternal Jehovah. And beside me, there is no Savior. There is. So, and he also says, besides me, there is no God. And there is no Elohim beside me. Properly to open wide. Look at the word Savior. Yasha, to set free. Open wide. Therefore, you are my witnesses. What's the word witness? A prince. You're my princes. What's the root of prince? To duplicate again. What is it saying, Luke? If your eye be single, fold it together. What does it say in Genesis 3:22? Unless you reach out your hand and take again and enfold from the open power, the power hand, open hand of the Lord, life, the Lord, self-existing eternal Jehovah, which is Jesus, and live forever. The scriptures are 100% behind Jonathan Kleck now. So there's no arguing it now. Just go look at all the folders. Now we have all this other cool stuff to show you, though. Look at this, man. Look how crazy this is. That's a tree. They made a tree. See the tree? And they made the trunk. And then look, the trunk bending here. And these are people. That's the head. That's the head. These are bodies. See the body, body, body. They're in a line walking that way. That's why they did it. They're the Adidas original, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. This is the evil. And guess who's awake? While we're trying to wake up, we're arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead. So here you go. Okay, Genesis 2:20, and Adam gave. Oh, I already showed you this. A part opposite, and Adam gave names to all the cattle of the, and all the cattle and all the fowl of the air and every beast of the field. For Adam, there was not a help. And there was not a meat for him, a part opposite. So a part opposite. So see, in any system, there has to be, see, one dimension goes to heaven, one dimension goes to the pit. There's a plane of existence in the middle, like a double-sided snow globe. And we're on it, we're in it, and we're stuck in the middle with you. And it's a twin system, and it's just like Cain and Abel, one right side up, good. The one that's right side up is good. The one that's upside down is bad. The elder twin is the one that's upside down, because the one that comes out first is the elder twin, which is just like referring to Genesis 1. The natural one comes first. Just read 1 Corinthians 15. That's all you got to do. Told you. Here it is. And then the younger twin, because he's got a, now what happens? What happens in a birth? Well, the younger one has to rotate and then come out. See, because he's facing up, but in order to birth, just like this holy nation that the Lord told me about, see, the younger twin has to turn upside down and then the birth happens, which is what we are. We're the final birth of the holy nation that was in the prophetic utterance he gave me. It all makes sense. There it is. Look, why Cain and Abel. Say it, Cainable. But see, the Skull and Bones Club, those super cool dudes, they know that you're trapped in a cannibalistic system. Okay, now let's keep going. Let's go to Job 11. Okay, let's go to Job 11. Job 11. For thou hast said, my doctrine is pure, and I am clean in thine eyes. But oh, that God would speak. Look at the word God here. Oh my gosh. That's Eloah. I recognize it. That's Hebrew word 433. Eloah. That's the singular form of Elohim. Oh my gosh. That Eloah would speak and open his lips against thee, and that he would show thee the secrets of wisdom. So here's Job talking about a singularity, Eloah, the singular form of Elohim. And he says that God would show you the secrets of wisdom. You want to see the secrets of wisdom? Let's go to Job 11. Freak out. Here we go. Ready? But oh, that God. See the word God right here? I told you, Eloah. The second form is rare. Okay, it's emphatically from Hebrew 4:10, which is El, the Almighty God. And Elohim is plural, guys. Many and what? So that he would show thee the secrets of wisdom. Look at this, show. To stand boldly out opposite, to manifest everything Jonathan Kleck has told you has been proven right. According to the word of God. Okay, all you false prophet hunters. I'm sorry, guys. Repent. That means turn back and go the other way. Look. That he would show thee the secrets of wisdom. Look. Here's how you see the secrets. To stand out boldly opposite. To manifest. To expose. Look. The secrets. A thing that is hid. How is it hidden? How is it hidden? It's in the down position. You got to invert it. It's the simplest thing in the world. It's the most paradoxical thing there is. And the night I got saved, the very first communication the Lord said was, Jonathan, read the text. Out of nowhere, I'm in a hotel room in the St. Anthony with Lou after a second high-speed chase with these lunatics. I'm like, who are these guys? I was like, I didn't know if they were like guys from the past, is stuff I used to be into. I was like, oh my God, I don't know who they are. And that's what was so concerning. Because the guys that I would have been dealing with, they don't wear suits. But if a guy's wearing a suit and you're in a high-speed chase with guys wearing suits, they should put a light up on the dash and pull you over. And that's not what was happening. It was like Born Identity crap. I was like, who are these guys? So then, then I had to get Lou out of town and blah, blah, blah. And that night at the St. Anthony Hotel, a blanket of energy. And I was like, what is going on? Jonathan, read the tags and the closure, Karen. I'm like, some source is communicating with me and he's telling me to read the tags and the closure. I'm carrying. I was like, okay. So I threw the tags down and I read the first tag and it said 100% nylon. It's like, I've lost my mind. It's like, the pressure got to me finally. I was like, oh shit. I said 100% nylon. That doesn't make any sense. And then I looked back down at it and I was like, 100%. And the Lord said, turn it upside down to stand boldly opposite. No lying. Woo! Got them, man. They're done. The enemy is done. Satan is done. That he should show thee the secrets of wisdom, that they are double to that which is. Oh my God, I forgot. That he would show thee, ready, to stand out boldly opposite, to manifest, to announce the secrets, the thing that is hid, of wisdom. Wisdom, skillfulness, wisdom, to be wise, that they are double to that which is. There it is. A duplicate. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem. Ah, freak out. It's all true. Jesus is real. El, the Almighty God, is real. Hell is real. There is a serpent race that's the host body system that's hunting the angel inside of you. That now I've said it exactly correct. There is a serpent system, host body, female energy from the pit that is hunting your spark of holiness, your soul. Are you at peace? You should be at peace. You should have a... I'm going to probably go to sleep with look like the Joker from the movie The Joker, just staring at the ceiling. It's so crazy. Okay, guys, look at what you're getting to see. You're getting to see absolute biblical proof. They don't show you this in churches. Look at this. Oh, my God. That which is, know therefore that God, oh my gosh, look at the word God, oh my goodness, look at this, know therefore, look at this, yada, the yada means to know, to ascertain by seeing, know therefore that Eloah, Eloah, it's singular form of Elohim, but it is emphatically 410, which means the Almighty exacteth to remit or to forget of thee less than thine iniquity deserveth. Oh my God, no kidding. Thank you so much. Canst thou by searching find out? Eloah, canst thou find out the Almighty unto perfection? It is as high as heaven, and what canst thou do deeper than hell? What canst thou know? Oh my gosh, you guys, you understand? It's higher than heaven and deeper than hell. It's always this, always. I just saw that. I've probably seen it before, but I have so much data, I'm overwhelmed. Okay, let's go to pictures, more pictures. Now, I told you we're being farmed by a race of locusts. Here's a band called Red Locust, and it's really coming out. I want you to look at, see, the girl's body is really just a suit of skin. There, the Skull and Bones Club know this. They're a bunch of locusts. Look at this. And then it also looks like it's having sex with her as well. Red Locust, the repercussions of shedding your skin. Look at that, guys. Look at what you're looking at, dude. Look at this. Look at all these eggs down in, like, the sewer. Oh, my God. That's what's going on. It's exactly what's going on. Okay, Habakkuk. What about Habakkuk? Thy bow was made quite naked, according to the host of the tribes. Thy bow, look, to bend, used only as a denominative for 3369, to set a trap. So let's go to Habakkuk 3:9. See, now the scriptures all bear it out. No matter where we go, it's going to bear it out, you guys. Habakkuk 3:9, always. It's always going to bear it out now, always. Thy bow was made quite naked. Thy bow, in the sense of bending. And then let's look up the root of the word. To be tough or severe, to be cruel, fiercer. That's that other race of beings. That's who they are. And they've been made naked. They're just hiding in flesh. To set a trap, to lay a snare. There they are. And it's female energy. And her bow was made quite naked because the virgin is the trap. Just like the red locust. You get it? Told you. Why do you think the Vatican's a snake with a bug in the mouth harvesting angels in the form of semen? Why? Because everything I told you is true. 100%. No lying. Okay, guys, I'm going to let this roll, man. I'm going to freak out. There's a lot more images. I want you to, you know what? If you want to see some imagery that I made for you guys, Dave and I spent some time on this. So you really should go look at these images of the crucifixion. Let me show you what I'm talking about. You see these images that we did of the crucifixion? Let me give you an example. Look at this. This represents you. The whole picture is you. There's an angel that's part of your essence. You're in a box. Picture the whole thing as a box. There's an angel and there's a demon. The angel, see, male energy goes to heaven, triangle. And then the female energy is a blue triangle that goes down. And it says demon right here. So good twin angel, that's the good twin. The bad twin's the demon. And then the reconciliation right here in the middle to fix this problem is Christ. But if you don't take the free gift of Christ, here's where the massive problem comes in. Let me show you. Okay, so you have heaven above with the open hand wanting to get you. But remember, what's the reconciliation of 3:2:2? You must stretch forth thine hand and take again in fold from God's open hand into you. Infold it, just like your eyes. Or if you don't take the free gift of Christ, see, the hell has a hold of you by this one right here. So this, the demon part of you goes down to hell, and hell's got a hold on you that way. So if you don't take the free gift of God, let me show you. I think I drew some pictures. Here you go. There you go. Watch. So here's the tattoo on the guy's back, right? Now, here it is. Here's what it looks like if you get saved. So there's three crosses. This is you, and this is you. This is you. But if you accept Christ as your Savior right here, then the triangle that's down gets turned up. You get two eyes that are up. One up, one up. This one got converted. So this down here, the pit cannot hold on to you with its attachment to you through this source. So it cuts that attachment. And then the open hand of God gets you. You get it? Because you turn to Him. That's it. Okay, let me give you another example. Here it is, like, yeah, here you go. Let's see. So here is someone that, let's see, here's the system that He's trying to get you in. So this represents you on the cross. There's an angel, you, and a demon. But see, you're attached to each other. So if you don't accept Christ, the pit, Satan, he takes the one that's still attached. You got to kill this attachment right here. And the way you kill that attachment is you invert it. You reduplicate it. It's the most obvious, stupidest thing in the world. Watch. So when you invert this, so this one gets turned up now instead of being down. So we put an X through this one. No more attachment because you're both up. Your eyes have become single, so you go back up. Get it? And you become the new Jerusalem, two hills founded and peaceful. And so the Skull and Bones Club, they know that you're in their Skull and Bones. They're Satanists. George Bush is a Satanist. They're Satanists. Sorry, they are. I'm just calling a Satanist a Satanist. That's what they are. Or they wouldn't say what they say. They wouldn't be in a thing called the Skull and Bones Club. It wouldn't be a secret. It wouldn't be some big secret. Why not just tell everybody? Well, because they're your masters. They own the flesh. They're like Adidas Original. And they're the ones, like, it's our host body. So if you don't get the rent paid on your host body, you go to hell and they get your soul. That's it. All right, guys. There's a lot more images in here. I'm gonna load this video up right now because I want it to get out. I want y'all to go read. You know what? Let me just. I know a lot of you guys won't do it, so I'm just gonna read every scripture real quick. Isaiah 14. Is this the man that made the world a wilderness and destroyed the cities thereof, and that opened not the houses of the prisoners? The word prisoner means to yoke or to hitch together in the sense of a battle, to bind fast. That's why right here in Isaiah 14, 17, the word prisoner means to yoke or to hitch together, to fasten in any sense to join in battle. They fasten you together in the Skull and Bones Club. You're fastened together. Okay, now, Luke, if your eye be single, your whole body's full of light. You guys already know that. I'm going to go into Revelation 21. Here we go. And he measured the wall thereof in 144 cubits according to the measure of a man. That is of the angel. Get it? According to the measure of the man. That is the angel. Because we're angels. I told you. We're angels. But they don't want you to know you're an angel. If you find out you're an angel, you'll be like, okay, that's it. No more y'all's bullshit. You're not just going to put up with it. Here we go. Wait a minute. Here we go. Wait a minute. Next one. Here we go. Psalm 146.9. The Lord preserveth the strangers. He relieveth the fatherless and the widow. But the way of the wicked he turneth upside down. Look what it means. To boast self, crooked, falsifying, deal perversely, to turn upside down, right here. But the way of the wicked, he turneth upside down. Look, you can't argue with that. The Lord turns the wicked upside down. So unless you turn back to him and get converted, turned up, then you're done. I mean, it's so obvious. Okay, let's see. What about Revelation 13? Blessed is he that readeth and they that hear the words of this prophecy. Look at the word readeth. Ana hinosko, to know up again. That's so crazy. So watch. Look at this. Here it is. Ana hinosko. Revelation chapter 1. Supremely blessed. The word blessed. Look at the word blessed. Look what it means. Supremely blessed. By extension, fortunate. Well off. Blessed. Let me ask you. Do you want to be extremely blessed? Yes or no? I do. I mean, that would be awesome. Okay, then pay attention. Blessed is he that readeth and they that hear the words of this prophecy and keep those things which are written therein. Look at the word readeth. Ana hinosko. Hinosko means to know absolutely. Like Jonathan Kleck said, 100% nylon. No, 100% no line. Properly up. To know up again. Absolutely. There it is. To know again. To know up again. Told you. 100% nylon, 100% no line. Oh my goodness. Wow. To know up again. Supremely blessed. Next. Here we go. So they're all in the folder. Everything's in the folder for you guys. What about the recovering of sight? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. He has sent me to preach deliverance to the captives and the recovering of sight right here to the blind. Look what the word recovering of sight is. 309, anablepsis, the restoration of sight by looking up. Ready? Okay, let's see what that's. Luke 4:18. I can't argue. Okay, ready? Luke chapter 4, verse 18. It's all in the folders, you guys. Here it is. The opening, the recovering of sight to the blind. Look right here. How do you recover your sight? It says the restoration of sight. It's two words. Anablepsis. Anablepsis. Ready? Here it is. To look up. To recover. Sight. To see. To receive sight. Up. I told you. Okay. Told you. It's it. From the beginning of the Bible. From the very beginning. From Genesis 3:2:2. To enfold, reach up, and take again from the tree of life. With everything that's going on in the world right now, aren't you glad to be able to have this kind of peace? How could you have peace without knowing the truth? How? No way. You can't do it. Okay, I got another one. Here's another one. Ready? What about, we just saw the recovering of sight, but the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him. Boy, have I seen those guys. Neither can they know them because they are spiritually discerned. Anakrino, to vigorously judge from down to up. Anakrino, there it is. Okay, guys, if you'll go through and you'll read every one of these definitions, look at every one of these. I've already done it for you. Guys, do you understand the effort it's taken to put all these folders together for you guys? Do you understand the effort it took to do that? I had to receive it first before I can give it to you. And now you can get ready. Watch this. Here's a good one. I told you, just like that rainbow thing. Like, look. So, ready? I'm going to use the Bible. Thy bow was made quite naked. So this is the virgin, right? So you want to play around. You want to touch the female thing. Neither shall you touch it, lest you die, because it inverts you. So I'm going to make her bow quite naked right now. Thy bow was made quite naked. There, just made her bow naked. It's really a dead sheep. Get it? Application of the Word of God. Okay, here's something super crazy. This is Jonathan Kleck before he got saved. Come out of the darkness into the light. Okay, that's me skydiving upside down. I'm on my back, obviously. I've got fangs on like a vampire. Think of Cain and Abel system. So there's like a representation of the bad Johnny. I've got lightning bolts on my sleeve. What are the odds? And I've got a V with fangs on my shoulders. I mean, what are the odds? And then it's come out of the darkness. Look at this. Out of the darkness into the light. Come on, man. And then I just happen to be sky surfing with the space shuttle launching, and I look like I'm crucified. And the Bible says we've been crucified with Christ. That's why you're... Okay, you couldn't think this up. You couldn't make it up. This is an obvious case of predestination, born identity, freak out of your mind. It's all true. It's all real. You're looking right at it. That was the Discovery space shuttle that I got to sky surf with. Yeah. A doctor bought me the ticket on the flight. A doctor that I trained to sky surf. He got me on the load. There it is. You can see my board. It's got the V with fangs and the bat underneath it. And that's yours truly, Johnny, right there. Sky surfing with the Discovery launching. And that's why I discovered Christ. No big deal. Okay, here we go. Let's talk about another scripture. Let's talk about 1 Peter. Jesus is the self-existent eternal Jehovah that says, look at this. So Jesus Christ, wherefore gird up the loins of your mind, be sober and hope to the end for the grace that shall be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, look at this. It's Yehoshua. See, Yehoshua in 3068 is the self-existent eternal Jehovah. And then Shua, that means saved. Jehovah saved. Jesus, ready? Jesus is the self-existent. You know why he's self-existent? Because he buys back his own energy that goes into the system, which is us. If you get bought back, you're part of that eternal light. Do you understand? He's the self-existent because love goes into the system and buys you back. That's why he's the self-existent eternal Jehovah. And then everything else burns. And then that's all part of his system too. So you don't want to be the part that burns. You want to be the part that gets redoubled. Eyes made single. You make peace with your father. He created you. Why not? Instead of you ran off and got involved with a bunch of prostitutes and wasted your substance on prostitutes and riotous living. Was it worth it? No. No, it wasn't. No. Okay. Now, I love you in Christ. There are the last three folders. If you'll just go watch every link. And you'll go look at every picture like I'm doing for you. You'll have this kind of shit-eating grin that I've got. Because it's like, what are they going to do to you? Kill you? Oh, no. Okay, so. Anyway. Yeah, the enemy hates that we can be full of joy. When you know the truth, you will be full of joy. Okay. All right, guys. I love you in Christ. Okay, let me grab my two lions because I gave one of my bears away, and my other bear's in the house, so hang on one sec. Okay, I think this is a very appropriate time for me to have the two lions representing Johnny the Lion, because this used to be Johnny, the good Johnny and the bad Johnny, and then God had mercy on me. He inverted me. My eyes became single. My whole body became full of light. And he made me a harbinger so I could help you. And that's why my name means Yahweh is given. That's what Jonathan means. And then Kleck means a messenger that rings the bell and gathers the church. What church is that? The one in Revelation 3, a letter to the church of the angel of Philadelphia. Now it's, you know, it's all true. Yeah. Open door, the key of David. Okay. This is you. I love you in Christ. Peace and grace. I hope that you have the confidence going into the
stage that we're going into. I mean, I don't know how long. I don't think it's long because, you know, tonight Iran is attacking Israel, I believe. And I saw Mike Pompeo said that can't happen without O'Biden's giving the okay. Like if Iran doesn't have some kind of like, oh, we won't, you know, we're not going to retaliate, they wouldn't do it. But if we stepped out of the way, then Iran will attack Israel. And, you know, the end of the world is all about Israel. And by the way, we are Israel. You, if you've been converted, you're Israel. I'm Israel. We're all Israel. But we're Jerusalem, founded and peaceful. Okay, guys. Anyway, I love you in Christ. Guys, every now and then I say, hey, support the ministry if you can. If you know how to do it, you can go to PayPal. It's jk@jonathankleck.com or P.O. Box 91281, San Antonio, Texas, 78209. So if you want to help us out, keep us rolling, that'd be great. If not, it's okay. I love you in Christ, and I'm so pleased that I got to show you that Genesis 3:22, showing us that if you don't reach out and take again from the tree of life and live forever, and the Lord let me show you what it is to reach out and take again. He let me show it to you in the Bible. Isaiah 40. It's proven now. Okay. Smiles from Johnny. I love you guys. Peace and grace. Okay. I'm going to let this roll. And, okay. I just love you guys. I'm so excited. I don't know what to say. Except, oh my God. It's all true, guys. Heaven's all true. Hell's all true, too. But heaven's all true. Being converted, you don't have to be afraid. You can be okay. You don't have to freak out. You can be at peace now, okay? And the people that haven't accepted it, you leave it with God. God doesn't ever miss one that's his. Do you understand? And the big trick was, they get born into our families. We get born into their families. And the flesh is the flesh, but the spirit is spirit. And we're spiritual beings, and we belong with our Father in heaven. We don't belong here. Okay? All right. I love you guys.